Guys, the SSD market has changed a lot since our last SSD update, and it's more of an evolutionary change than a revolutionary change. The all-new Samsung 840 EVO has taken the market by storm. It uses the same cost-effective TLC flash as the older 840, but delivers performance in a real-world scenario that is closer to what the older 840 Pro was capable of doing with a consumer-grade workload. So one of the most obvious improvements with the new EVO is more capacities, 120, 250, 500, 750, and 1 terabyte capacities are all available for this new drive, making it extremely competitive with other options on the market, such as the Crucial M500. They're 7 millimeters thick, meaning that you can install them in even slim notebooks as long as they do accept a 2.5 inch form factor drive. And they're using the same Cortex 3-core processor as we found in the previous generation drives, but now it's clocked at 400 megahertz versus 300 megahertz. And with the performance that we see out of this drive, it's pretty obvious that there's more to this than just flash performance, because typically, whenever there's a die shrink that goes on NAND flash, we get less reliability and less performance. But the way to compensate for that is better controller algorithms, and well, mostly better controller algorithms and better binning, of course, on the flash. So Samsung, in spite of the fact that they're using 10 nanometer class flash, has managed to achieve fantastic performance, huge capacity, and aggressive pricing. What the processor also takes care of is full AES 256-bit encryption. Now, if you forget your passkey, don't worry, you can recover the drive using the code on the back. However, that will wipe all of the data. So this is a great feature for data security, but not something that I'd recommend using if you're the kind of person who forgets to tie your shoelaces in the morning, so to speak. Now, Samsung has completely overhauled their SSD magician software and their data transfer wizard. The data transfer wizard, I think, is not getting talked about enough, because now it not only clones your old drive over to your new SSD, but it can even take extra data like large movies and music and photo collections and overflow those onto secondary storage automatically for you. It also includes the option to enable what they're calling Turbo Write, which takes part of the flash on the SSD and runs it in sort of a pseudo SLC mode. If you guys have kept up with flash technology over the last few years, you'll know that SLC is typically faster and more reliable than MLC, which is typically refers to 2 bits per cell, and then TLC is 3 bits per cell, and you sort of see speed decreases each way you go. So by running some of the flash in SLC mode, you're able to take advantage of SLC-like performance, and then what happens is it actually dumps that more slowly onto the flash that's running in TLC mode. So it's great for burst performance, like what you'd see on a desktop, while for users who are going to do a ton of writes over the entire drive constantly and need the best endurance possible, the 840 Pro is probably still going to make more sense in the long run. The next thing where things get really interesting is real-time acceleration processing of I/O data, or as Samsung likes to call it, RAPID. The Magician software uses the RAM of your system to create a mini RAM disk cache to boost performance even more. So it's capable of using up to 1 gigabyte of system RAM, requires Windows 7 with at least a 1 gig processor and 2 gigs of RAM, although I wouldn't recommend using half of your RAM to cache your drive if you only have 2 gigs of RAM. So I would personally only really recommend doing this if you have anywhere from 4 to 8 gigs of RAM, probably on the 8 gig side. And while unfortunately we weren't really able to benchmark these features, I do recommend heading over to somewhere like AnonTech, where their review of the 840 EVO was very comprehensive and outstanding, so you can see how this actually affects real-world data. What we can say is that based on user feedback that we've seen so far and based on the guys who do have the equipment to run this correctly, it makes a tangible difference. The days of SSDs being all about the performance that's inside this actual little box are gone. It's going to be more about the software that comes along with it to make it a great experience for the end user. Last thing though is if you are using any kind of RAM caching, I do recommend running your system on a UPS or uninterruptible power supply, because while it doesn't do much write caching, it's predominantly read caching, it can still cause data corruption if your system experiences sudden power loss no matter what. So thank you for checking out this SSD update featuring the Samsung 840 EVO. Don't forget to subscribe to NCIX Tech Tips for more videos like this from NCIX.com.